RAF meteors at Duxford Airfield near Cambridge come in for close inspection by Marshal Tito, Communist President of Yugoslavia. Some of Britain's finest and most modern aircraft are on show for his visit. Most of them are jets, and in these the Marshal shows an especial interest. Among the pilots with whom the Marshal chats is Neville Duke, who later was to break through the sound barrier. Now the meteors taxi out to the runway to take part in the flypast. Marshal Tito fires the very pistol that starts the show. A Canberra jet bomber dips its wings in salute as it flies across the airfield at low level. Now meteors fly in formation past the Marshal. As two peel off for a display of aerobatics, their wingtips touch, and the Marshal jumps to his feet as they crash in flames some miles away, killing both pilots. A tragic ending to the display. The Marshal's visit to our country ends, and the now familiar motor cavalcade arrives at Westminster Pier. Mr. Anthony Eden and Admiral Sir Roderick MacGregor join the Marshal in inspecting the Guard of Honour. Marshal Tito says his farewells, and in the launch, Knorr leaves to join his own warship at Greenwich. The visit of the Yugoslavian president has done much to establish closer collaboration between the two countries.